Good evening, it's 6:31, and I'm going to call this meeting to order. This meeting of the Denville Township Board of Education is being held in accordance with the Open Public Meetings Act. Notice this meeting was provided to the Daily Record and/or the Star Ledger of Morris County, has been delivered to the Township Clerk, and has been posted on the bulletin board of the Board of Education office and in each of the school buildings in the district. Roll call, please.
Mr. Capello?
Here.
Mrs. Wagner?
Here.
Mr. Cass? Mr. Kim?
Here.
Dr. Aruna Detassan?
Here.
Dr. Moore?
Here.
Mr. Anderson?
Here. We do not have a need for executive session yet, so we're going to move on to our Pledge of Allegiance. Okay, we are, let's see, special presentations we'll have later, our strategic planning. We'll move on to superintendent's comments.
Just a reminder, we're going to do the reorg meeting at 6 p.m. on January 3rd. And had a good productive meeting with Ms. Dallas last week to catch her up on all the things that are going on in the district. That's it for my comments.
Thank you, Dr. Forte.
No, she's not.
Okay. Mrs. Kurowski, business administrator's comments?
No comments.
We're going to open up for our first public comment discussion for agenda items only. And we're going to open up at 6:34 p.m. If anybody would like to make a comment, please come up to the microphone, state your name and address for the record. I do not see anybody besides for our group online. I'll keep an eye on that also.
Cindy's online moderating, right, Cindy?
Okay, seeing no one in person come up and seeing no one raise their hand in the meeting, I'm going to close our first public comment section at 6:34 p.m. and move on to our agenda. Mr. Capello, would you come up and let us do old business, please?
Sure. If there are no objections, I would like to move under old business A, B, and C. A are the points from November 2, of Treasurer's and Monies and Board Secretary, Education Reports, Reports of Student Enrollment, Report of the Health Office from November 22, also HIV Case BB222304, HIV Case BB222305, and the attached to your calendar for 2023-2024 school year. And finally, the minutes from our work session and executive session meetings 1 and 2 of November 14, 22, as well as regular session and executive session meeting November 28, 22.
Second.
Thank you, Mr. Capello and Mr. Kim. Any questions, comments? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Mr. Capello?
Yes.
Mrs. Wagner?
Yes.
Mr. Kim?
Yes.
Dr. Aruna Detassan?
Yes.
Dr. Moore?
Yes.
Mr. Anderson?
Yes. Okay, under new business, Mrs. Wagner, would you mind moving this to personnel, please?
Certainly. If there are no objections, I would like to move items 1 through 5 personnel. I just want to bring your attention to the addendum item 1L. This is resignations, retirement. hour adjustments.
Second.
Thank you, Mrs. Wagner, Mr. Kim. And apologies, did you, you mentioned the addendum also, right? Thank you. Any questions, comments? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Mr. Capello?
Yes.
Mrs. Wagner?
Yes.
Mr. Kim?
Yes.
Dr. Abumendetazin?
Yes.
Dr. Moore?
Yes.
Mr. Anderson?
Yes. And Mr. Capello, back to you, if you would mind moving us to instruction and program, please.
I'd be happy to. If there are no objections under instruction and program, I would like to move items 1 through 8. These include actually no current workshop expenses, but we do have thought students from MCST to observe at Lakeview School, as well as students from CCM and Morris Knowles to participate at our schools. And also Len William Patterson, so yep, also the attached list of features.
Second.
Thank you, Mr. Capello. Mr. Kim, any questions, comments? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Mr. Capello?
Yes.
Mrs. Wagner?
Yes.
Mr. Kim?
Yes.
Dr. Abumendetazin?
Yes.
Dr. Moore?
Yes.
Mr. Anderson?
Yes. And Mr. Kim, would you mind moving to policy revisions?
Sure, I'd be happy to. I motion that we approve, approve for first reading policy P1950 school visitors.
Second.
Thank you, Mr. Kim and Mrs. Wagner. Any questions, comments? And Dr. Forte, you mentioned that this was the policy that you had worked with the staff in the building. Is that correct?
Yes. The policy on visitors is changed, updated to try to help just make sure that no unwanted visitors are in the building. We just wanted to tighten up the wording, and the attorney gave us the wording we had there.
Excellent. Thank you. Any questions or comments on that one policy? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Mr. Capello?
Yes.
Mrs. Wagner?
Yes.
Mr. Kim?
Yes.
Dr. Abumendetazin?
Yes.
Dr. Moore?
Yes.
Mr. Anderson?
Yes. Mr. Kim, would you mind moving us through finance, please?
Sure. I motion tonight that we approve Section D, finance. Number one, the list of checks that's outlined on the table. Please note that checks 13890 through 13996 are void due to an error, printing error. Number two, we approve the attached amended 2022 calendar of meetings. Number three, to approve the attached agreement for the purchase of natural gas services and the purchase of electric generation services through the Alliance for Competitive Energy Services bid. Number four, to approve the attached corrective action plan for the milk program audit recommendation for the year ending June 30th, 2021. And number five, to approve the attached agreement for the Pay School Central application to manage the payments transactions for school-related purchases for 2023 to 2024 school year.
Do I have a second?
Second.
I actually have a question, please. The amended 2022 calendar meetings is just basically to change the time to 6 p.m., correct?
That is correct. Yes, that's for the reorganization meeting at the town hall at 6 p.m. Originally, it was scheduled for 7. There's a conflict with the town.
Thank you. And just to let the rest of the board know, in case they didn't get a chance to read the minutes, this number 5 is the revisit of that payment application, and Damaris was able to get that annual fee reduced significantly. So I believe it's under $1,000 per year now.
Thank you very much for pointing that out. I did see that, and appreciate Damaris and the team working on it. I think all of us agreed it's a good direction to go into, and certainly makes everybody's life a little bit easier if that's the direction that people want to use for payments. So it's great. Thank you. Any other questions, comments?
Just one. Thank you, Damaris, for all the hard work on the school pay thing. The only thing I would ask is, this is going to be an annual contract.
That is correct, yes.
Only thing I would ask is if you wouldn't mind a reminder for the next year, we could look at the fees, like 4.5%. Like to just look at it next year and see if, you know, if we maybe can compare that piece along. Not that that's on us. I know that the payer is paying that, but it's, as credit card fees go, they seem a lot. So I'm not totally fine with this for now, but I'd like to maybe look at it next year, especially specifically that piece.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Any other questions, comments? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Mr. Capello?
Yes.
Mrs. Wagner?
Yes.
Mr. Kim?
Yes.
Dr. Aruna Ditasan?
Yes.
Dr. Moore?
Yes.
Mr. Anderson?
Yes. And Mr. Cass is not here, but we don't have anything under operations, correct, Damaris?
That is correct.
Thank you very much. And we'll move on to go to the cause. Committee reports, correspondence, discussion items. Obviously, we will pause after we go through A, B, and C, because D will be our strategic planning portion, which will begin at 7:30 p.m. But for under A, B, and C, under good of the cause, if anybody has anything, please speak up.
So if you don't mind, we met myself, Mr. Kim, and Mr. Cass met with Dr. Forte since the last meeting about the acknowledgement form. So if you saw the notes that Dr. Forte put together, there'll be a Google form on the website that they'll communicate to the public about, and it'll be to nominate any current or past student of this district and acknowledge them for, and the form will have the guidelines, but acknowledge them for some outstanding performance in sports or academics or some other extracurricular activity.
Thank you for putting that together as quickly as all of you did. I appreciate it. I know I sent over a couple of questions, and there was nothing in particular. I thought it was really well put together and appreciate it. Anybody have any questions for more in the committee on that?
The only thing I wanted to share is Mike had emailed about, and this came up during our conversation. We talked about acknowledging if Valley View has a sport, and I think what the committee had discussed was, regardless of whether, I think the example we used was if they are doing cross country for Valley View, and then they're doing cross country with the rec team, and they won an award for rec, that we would choose to recognize them for that, even if Valley View hadn't been awarded something that year.
Okay, that's great. And then the only other question I think I had was the question of, like, teams or groups that have Denville residents and non-Denville residents. I think we'll run into that quite a bit when there's kind of mixed. Was the plan to acknowledge the entire group of individuals or team, or at least invite them, and then whoever decides, obviously the non-Denville residents may not show up, or was the plan to only invite Denville residents, or what was that discussion?
Yeah, it was my thought process that we invite the whole team. Of course, if there were any like special awards like MVP or, you know, special acknowledgement, then, you know, if they were a Rockaway resident, it may not make sense to, but, you know, if they were a Denville resident, we certainly could acknowledge them in addition to the whole team. So, we would invite the whole team.
Good. Thank you. I agree with that. I think it makes sense, right? If they want it together as an organization or a group, they should be acknowledged together. And if they don't, obviously, I know other people in other towns may or may not decide to come, and that's perfectly fine. The only other question I had was, I know that the South Orange Maplewood form stated staff too. Was the plan to just do students on this one, at least for now? I know we have other ways that we acknowledge staff, and that's why.
I think that's what we discussed, is just doing students, yeah.
Makes sense. I know we've got other ways to acknowledge staff accomplishments, so. Awesome, thank you.
They could be former students, though, according to our...
Correct, saw that, yep.
So they could be adults.
Yep.
That are, like, maybe the valedictorian or somebody did something special in college or something like that.
Got it, yep. Nope, that totally makes sense. And the only other thing I think I noted was just on the section that says valedictorian or salutatorian was to just note non-Valley View, since obviously we acknowledge those individuals at a Board of Education program, so. Any other questions for that? Any other good of the cause under A, B, or C? Board meeting highlights. Dr. Forte, obviously, strategic planning we'll have on there.
I have three. The recognition program, ready to go. We're up and running. That's the acknowledgement program that we just spoke about. Pay school app and the strategic plan meeting three.
With me, very good. Okay, and no one has anything else for good of the cause. Okay. We're gonna add a section in here. So we are at good of the cause. We've gone through A, B, and C. We're gonna hold off on D, which is our strategic planning meeting at 7:30. We do have a need for a second or an executive session, excuse me. So with that, if somebody, Dr. Forte, can you just remind us what it's for? I know security is one of them, right?
Security, legal, and student matters.
Okay. Mr. Capello, would you mind bringing us the executive?
I move to convene the executive session in accordance with Section 8 of the Open Public Meetings Act. The purpose of this closed session will be to discuss legal, security, and student matters.
And personnel.
And personnel. Minutes of this session will be made available to the public when the need for confidentiality no longer exists.
Second.
Thank you, Mr. Capello. Mrs. Wagner, all in favor?
Aye.
Any nays? No. Any abstentions? No. We are in executive session at 6:49 p.m.
All right. Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us for our third strategic planning meeting. Once again, my name is Mike Anderson. For those of you who have not been here, I'm the president of the Denville Board of Education, and I first want to thank all of you for coming this evening. For those of you who have not been here, this is our third meeting, and I welcome all of you. I thank you for being here. We've had a great turnout for all of our meetings, including this evening. And really, you know, just as a reminder of why we're here and what we're trying to accomplish, these strategic planning meetings give us a roadmap for the next 5 years with the district. Really, when we invite stakeholders in, staff members, parents, community members, business owners, the Denville police have been involved, the township leadership has been involved, to really help us understand where they see the district in 5 years. And then it is our job from the Board of Education to really spend the next 5 years building out goals on an annual basis to meet those that five-year plan. So I thank you all for being involved. This evening, though, I'm just gonna take a couple minutes out of our strategic planning meeting and invite Laura Wagner up. Laura is a board member that has been on the board for the past 6 years. And tonight is Laura's last Board of Education meeting. So I wanted to just thank her for her 6 years of dedicated service to the board. The board would like to give you a small memento of our appreciation for your work. The board is a lot of work, and Laura has done a phenomenal job, including president for probably the most difficult time in history to be the president during the pandemic and handled it wonderfully. And I thank you for your service and your dedication to the community. So thank you very much. With that, I'd like to turn the meeting over to Charlene Peterson from New Jersey School Board Association. She facilitates these meetings. And before I do that, I just want to say thank you to Charlene, Dr. Forte, Dr. Cullis, Damaris, the entire staff, the school board team that has been here. It's a lot of work to put these meetings on, and they've done a phenomenal job, so thank you to them. But I'm going to turn it over to Charlene.
Good evening, everyone. It really is a pleasure to have everyone here, and you know, Denville just continues to keep turning out. I mean, a lot of times, you know, the meetings sometimes as they progress, there's sometimes fewer people, and but Denville just keeps, you know, keeps showing their support for the schools. So we really do appreciate it. So like you said, tonight is our third and final meeting of the work that we're going to do here. So the first two meetings, we were providing input, and now tonight we're going to use that input then to do the, you know, you mentioned a roadmap. So that's what we're going to do tonight. We're going to write, or we're going to develop that roadmap using the input from the first two meetings. So I'm just going to kind of take you through again the steps of what your job is for tonight, so that when you break into your groups, you know, you'll be able to hit the ground running with the work that you need to do tonight. So we always start out again, and you know, I'm happy to see that we had some new people here tonight who said they've not been here before. So really, and that's how this process really, you know, helps bring in as many members of the community as we can. You know, appreciate you being here in whatever number of meetings you can come. So we always start out kind of talking about that common definition, or you know, what do we think strategic planning, why are we here? And it's to develop that common vision that's, you know, meaningful to your community about student achievement. What is it that we, you know, that you as a community want for your students, and how are we going to work together to help make that happen? So we walked through a process. So in the first meeting, we answered the question, where are we now? And that started out with a saying, is what we're talking about helping support this? Are we in alignment with this mission statement? So, you know, last time we said, okay, you know, we had the strengths, the challenges, we had the visions, but before everything was divided by what table number, you know, came up with the input, we said, okay, if we had to take all the strengths and the challenges, all the visions, and say we only had like four buckets to put them in, what would those buckets look like? So, and I think people were probably would not be surprised, like, you know, operations would be, you know, all the work we talked about with the buildings and having to make sure that we need to be able to have accommodate the growth that's coming. So we know then that that's an area that needed to be talked about. There was a lot of talk about social emotional learning and kind of the health and wellness of our staff and students. So that's where the caring culture came from. We know that student success is the work that we do here, so there always needs to be a student achievement bucket. And then also, you know, we can't do this work without connecting with our family and with our community, so that always needs to be a focus of our work as well. So those are the four areas then that are going to drive tonight's work. So when you came in, you know, you were asked to kind of self-select an area of interest to you, so that those are, you know, kind of the goal, the four goal areas. So all the strengths, challenges, and visions were resorted then by these four areas. So one of the things that when you get to the table, at each table then for each person, so like in the family and community connections, is all the strengths, the challenges, and the visions sorted by that goal area. So grab that sheet when you get to your table. So first I'm just gonna kind of take you a little bit through the process of writing a goal statement, and then I'll reinforce again kind of, you know, how to use this data. So again, just gonna kind of take you through what this looks like. So when we talk about developing a goal statement, I'm gonna think about one big, broad, overarching statement. This is a five-year plan, so this statement has to be big enough, it has to be broad enough, it has to be so that it is still effective, it's still meaningful after a five-year period. Then we need to take that big, broad statement and say, okay, we need to break it down into a little bit more meaningful parts, because if it's so big and it's so broad, how is the administration going to be able to, how are they going to be able to write the action plans that mirror what it is that, what we're expecting or that we're asking for? So we need to break it down a little bit more then to kind of into some meaningful parts. And I'll show some examples of that in just a minute. So as we look at then writing a goal statement, basically saying that first we are going to take, even break that into parts and saying, okay, like, what do we want to accomplish? Like, what's the action verb? So in this case, it was to, in the example I'm giving, to create. So what is it that we want to impact? In this example, a safe and secure learning environment. So that what will the outcome do for you? Equipped to deliver 21st century programs. So this is kind of the process, and it's, this is on the back of all of your agendas, so that when you get in your small groups, you have that to look at. But just kind of a way to help you think as you're constructing this goal statement, kind of what the component parts of a goal statement can look like. So in this example, you know, this group here were their visions, their strengths, their challenges. Their goal area was kind of looking at facilities and safety. So that there was that goal statement that we had to create a safe and secure learning environment equipped to deliver 21st century programs. So that was the big broad goal statement, and said, okay, well then now let's break it down a little bit more. What do we mean by that? So I said, well, we want to upgrade the facilities to be more energy and cost efficient. Okay, we can, that would give the administration some direction to write some action plans, right, about what that could look like. Increasing internal and external community at all the schools, again, gives some direction. We're not telling them how to do it, and that's another important part of this, is making sure that we stay, that our thinking stays at that strategic level, that our thinking stays at that higher level, and we're giving big, broad, you know, we're giving direction, but not in the how, kind of saying we're taking this big broad what and breaking it down into some smaller what's, and then upgrade the existing facilities to be more structurally modernized. So now you can see that we took that one statement, broken down into some smaller parts, and so now you can see then how you can develop a five-year plan from that without being too prescriptive of telling them how to do it, but giving them enough direction to know what we're talking about, to know what direction we want them to go, and to kind of lay out the roadmap here. So that really then will be your job for tonight then, is kind of just with that example I just showed of writing that big, that first big overarching statement, and then supporting objectives to go with it. Again, and like I said, staying at that strategic level. So, you know, and then similarly to what we did last time, you know, in the previous times of when you break into your small groups to first start out introducing yourselves, kind of talking about what your connection to the district is, making sure that our conversations stay focused on the big picture. And really tonight, because we, you know, are thinking strategically and we're writing strategic goals, we almost have to stay at that level because we are writing a roadmap for the whole district. Kind of the challenge sometimes when you have a large group is, you know, in the past we had 10 tables, right, that you all split up at. So now we only have 4 tables because each goal area is a table. So now there may be larger groups sitting at each one of the tables. So one of the things that you'll find when you get into your groups is, so kind of took all the strengths, the challenges, and the visions that are, you know, and these sheets are at the table, and there are kind of guiding categories under them. So what you might want to do is kind of take your big group and break it up into smaller subgroups. So like you, like let's say in caring culture, there's, you know, the group will be looking at SEL, the group will be looking at culture awareness, the group will be looking at a supportive environment and different district pathways. So you might, if you've got a large table, you might say, okay, let's some of you work on, you know, the objective that might, you know, accommodate this area. Some of you talk about this, some of you talk about that. So you might decide at your table how you want to handle this and recognize that if it's too challenging for you to just all in one group write one statement and write all the objectives together, recognize that you might want to take the work and divvy it up a little bit based on some of the subparts that would go with this. So in each one of the sheets that are at your table, they're first on one side are kind of the big ideas that were pulled out of this. And this I got from help from the administration. I took all the strengths, the challenges, the visions, and left them kind of as in a spreadsheet type thing, and said, you know, like, what are the things that kind of speak to you? Like, what are the things that you're maybe kind of working on or direction you were kind of thinking, so that we don't say go right and the district's already going left, right? So we just kind of, I asked them for some help or some input on what, as they looked at your listing of things, what are some things that might be considered big ideas? So that's on the front of each one of your sheets. And then on the back of each one of the sheets at the tables are then the actual data or the actual input. So you might start looking at kind of the big ideas, and then as you're helping write a statement from it, look at the actual data to kind of help support your thinking. And so like I said, you know, we would like you to be able to self-select. But one of the things we also hope is that the goal areas need to be somewhat even. So like if there's maybe say 30 people that want to go somewhere and only 5 people that want to go somewhere else, we might, you know, ask if there's volunteers that might want to move to their table, just so that we're trying to get, you know, some even input here. So each one of you should have identified what table you want to go to. So I'm going to give about an hour here. So the kind of what want each table to come back with is for your goal area, writing a goal statement, a big overarching goal statement, and then writing the sub objectives, say no more than 5, that will kind of go underneath to support your goal statement. And it should be not the how, but we're going to keep all of our conversation focused on the what. So even almost the objectives kind of look like mini goal statements: to do this, to accomplish this, to, you know, so kind of making sure that we are staying in that lane. Anyone have any questions before we kind of go into our different areas? Okay, yep, you guys are all pros at this, right? So we're going to go ahead then. You can kind of see the 4 tables are in the back there. So kind of find, again, the area that was of interest to you. And then we'll kind of see how it shakes out in terms of being evenly distributed or not. on? It's not on? Now it is. Now it is. It just takes it a minute, yeah. Okay, if we could have everyone come back to their seats, please. Okay, so whoever's going to be reporting out for the student success group to come up. Okay, everyone, can we come back so that we can hear the great work that's taken place tonight? I just wanted to first, before I turn it over, just really say thank you to everyone. I think that as we were walking around, the conversations in your groups are really amazing, and you guys just got right to it and did some really great work tonight. So I'm really excited to see what this plan is going to look like. So I am going to turn it over to the student success to get us started.
Okay, so we were the student success group. Our goal statement was to provide academic curricula that is engaging, challenging, and student-centered, empowering all learners to achieve success. Our objectives are to design practices and structures that develop critical thinking in all areas, to provide tools and authentic opportunities within school and community for students to excel in leadership, to develop and enhance existing programs to encompass all learners, and to expand opportunities for the exploration of the arts.
So much fun. All right, so we looked at the goal statement. Continue to provide sustainable, safe facilities incorporating cutting-edge technology in a fiscally responsible manner to support modern learning styles. So our objectives. The first one, modernize sustainable, expanded learning spaces to ensure learner equality as feasible. So what we say with that, and what we mean is, it's not just go build a building. Can you do outdoor classrooms, modernize the spaces you have to better meet the needs of the students and the modern learners? Maintain and ensure Denville continues to lead in providing a safe and secure environment, both physically and virtually. So, you know, there's the different changes and threats depending on where you are and you need to look at it. Increase the percentage of non-tax revenue as compared to traditional funding sources. Are there opportunities to generate revenue, to pursue different grants, different things like that? And last one, upgrade the technology backbone of the district to support the entire school community and optimize facility functions. You know, can every kid get on a video streaming for a website at the same time? Is that something? That should be one of those objectives and goals to reach. You know, can we control building facilities without being in the building? Different things to look at. There's other ways to do this kind of stuff, and we hope we can get there.
Okay, family and community connections.
So for family and community connections, we did to increase connections between the schools, community programs, and all stakeholders to enhance positive student outcomes. And our objectives were to build ways to reach out to the entire community beyond the students and their families. So we talked a lot about involving households that do not have students within the schools and making sure we have their support for things with referendums and budgets, and to make sure they have a stake in understanding that the better schools are the better property values, and to make sure we have communication with them as well. To streamline and enhance communication coming from the school by using a universal system. We have dreams of a simple system that goes across all schools and everyone can access what they need easily. Our third one was create relationships and partnerships with third-party community facilities and organizations, and we talked a lot about using other organizations in reaching out to the benefit of both the schools and them. The idea we had of maybe if the ice cream social's going on, we also have a, or maybe that's even later actually, but I think that's my next one I'm jumping ahead to. But using other community organizations to help support the schools and the students and the parents. Find effective and creative ways to engage parents in education and learning process. So that was our idea of something like the ice cream socials going on. Perhaps there's also an area that parents can go to and learn the new math curriculum. But finding ways to help the parents and keep them engaged in what's going on. And then finally, promote student involvement in civic duties and volunteerism through relatable and age-appropriate experiences, making sure the kids understand civics and what makes the government work and how to get things accomplished.
Friend. We were like talking a lot, so we finally were the last to finish. So we were caring culture, and we created the goal statement to state to create a safe and comfortable learning environment so that students and staff are empowered to be their authentic selves. So we basically wanted to make sure that everyone felt like it was okay to, you know, make a mistake or learn a different way or just mess up and not have the class or the rest of the building, you know, laugh at you. So, you know, be their authentic selves and be empowered to do so. So in order to get that way, the objectives, one of which are to develop a vertically aligned progression throughout the district of social emotional skills. So we really, like, our point in creating that objective was really so that every school does have something set forth, you know, the pride, the, you know, the rockets, but we wanted to make sure that everyone was doing kind of the same thing so that we can touch base and you know, just have everything known district and district-wide and the parents understand it very easily too. The second objective was to celebrate, and this was more about cultural awareness, to celebrate individuality through exposure, education, and acceptance. And again, we feel like that is being done a lot in the school already, but we just want to make sure that we continue to do so in really specific ways. And that's the next group's job, so good luck with that, to make it even better. The third objective would be to invest in consistent support. Which one is this one? So. We were talking about supportive environment. So this was to invest in consistent support to meet all learning preferences through tiered resources and professional development. So this is really more geared towards the teachers and making sure that the teachers had the resources and the professional development to help the different learning styles of our students. The last objective was to create consistent systems. What was that one all about? District pathways, maybe? Possibly. So it was to create consistent systems to nurture students' development and foster upstanders across all schools. So that was more, again, about, you know, supportive environment and making sure that, like, there is a, the kids who maybe are not necessarily doing the right thing, we can pinpoint those particular kids and help them be the teachers of what our acronyms are all about. And we were talking a lot about role plays with that and utilizing the role play model. Did I get it all?
Thank you so much to everyone. So can you see now how this work all came together and how as a group you developed a plan and how you really can see what the future for that your district can look like 5 years from now, right? Based on this roadmap that we've developed. So like I said, we did our job, right? We did the what, we provided this roadmap. So now the next piece of it is to have the how, you know, accomplished, laying out the steps to do this. And then once everything is all together, what we do is I'll come to a future board meeting to deliver the plan and kind of do a management overview of this process. And we'd like to invite everyone to come back to that meeting so that you can kind of see that final plan and again, you know, be formally thanked for all the work that you did. So we will be in contact with you about when that will be. And then, like you said, you'll be able to see then how this all came together. So again, really appreciate everything that you have done, all your work. You really took this in stride, and I'm really excited about the outcome here. So just wanted to say thank you to everyone and excited about where your school district is going in the next 5 years. So thank you.
Okay, welcome back to our Board of Education meeting. We just completed under good of the cause, D other, our strategic planning session with the public. And we're now gonna open up for our second open public comment section. This portion of the meeting is open to any individuals for the purpose of addressing resolutions on this agenda or matters that they find important to the Board of Education and is governed by Board Policy 0167. Prior to making a comment, members of the public are required to state their names, addresses, and the subject matter of the comment. Comments are limited to 3 minutes per person. No participant may speak more than once on the same topic until all others who wish to speak on that topic have been heard. comments made by members of the public may or may not be responded to by the board or district administration. Any response that is provided will be made at the end of the public comment period after all comments have been heard. The board asks that members of the public be courteous and mindful to the rights of other individuals when speaking. Students and employees have specific legal rights afforded by the laws of New Jersey. Therefore, comments regarding specific students and employees will not be responded to by the board. The board bears no responsibility, nor will it be liable for any comments made by members of the public. Members of the public should consider their comments in light of the legal rights of those affected or identified in their comment and be aware that they are legally responsible and liable for their comments. All statements, questions, or inquiries shall be directed to the board president. I'm going to open this public comment section at 9:12 p.m. Anybody who would like to make a comment can come up to the podium, state their name and address for the record. Dr. Forte, can you just confirm we don't have any questions or raised hand in the Google Meet?
There's no one in the Google Meet.
Okay, excellent. So I will close our second public comment section at 9:13 p.m. We do not have a need for executive. Is that correct, Dr. Forte?
Correct.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
Thank you, Mrs. Wagner. Thank you, Mr. Capello. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any nays? None. Any abstentions? None. We are closed at 9:13 p.m.